Lou Goff. I'm Ansley Puckett.
And I'm Matthew Mills, and you're watching LETV.
On April 23rd, there will be an NHS meeting in the auditorium during first lunch.
On Monday, April 23rd, there will be an FCA rally from 6:30 to 8 in the auditorium. Worship will be led by Friendship Baptist Church Praise Band. The keynote speaker will be founder of Awaken International Ministries, Algernon Tenson, with a guest testimony from Elijah Blackman.
Prom will take place on April 27th. The theme is Arabian Sunset, and the tickets are on sale for $25. You can purchase these in student services.
The Spanish Club will be hosting a spring gardening party on May 10th.
The ROTC Summer Camp will take place from June 10th to June 16th. See the ROTC instructor for an application.
Time is running out to buy a yearbook. If you want to remember this year forever, you can go online or see Ms. Proctor in room 410 to buy a yearbook. They are $80 and availability is limited.
In light of the recent Facebook data scandal, which compromised the private information of millions of people, lawmakers in Congress wanted to know what went wrong that allowed this security breach to happen on the world's largest social media website.
On March 17th, The Guardian and The New York Times exposed a shocking revelation that private information was stolen from Facebook by Cambridge Analytica, a data firm with ties to President Trump. This number was later revised to as many as 87 million Facebook users whose private information was stolen, including the information of Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg. In light of this, lawmakers called on Zuckerberg to testify before Congress to get more information on how this data breach was able to occur and what Facebook was doing to help keep users' information private. Zuckerberg appeared before the Senate Judiciary and Commerce Committees, which he and his company handled well. He repeated his apology, saying that Facebook made a huge mistake and that his company was not taking a broad enough view of its responsibilities. Zuckerberg appeared before the House Energy and Commerce Committee, where he was grilled stronger than the hearing with the Senate. Rep. Frank Pallone, a Democrat from New Jersey, asked for a yes or no answer if Facebook would commit to changing its default settings to minimize data collection. Zuckerberg responded, saying that it was a complex issue that cannot be solved with a one-word answer, to which Rep. Pallone said that he was, quote, disappointed. Multiple legislators also raised the point that Facebook's data policies violated a 2011 agreement with the Federal Trade Commission after a prior privacy complaint. The FTC confirmed last month that it is investigating Facebook. The data scandal wiped away tens of billions of dollars from Facebook's market value and created a political unrest from both sides of whether or not Facebook was violating users' right to privacy.
A scandal like this raises the question of whether or not Zuckerberg should step down as CEO of his own company.
This past weekend, Ansley and I had the pleasure of seeing the school production of Legally Blonde, and here's our take of what we got from the play the night of.
I recently saw Legally Blonde the musical. It tells the story of Elle Woods, a sorority girl who enrolls at Harvard Law School to win back her ex-boyfriend Warner. She discovers how her knowledge of law can help others and successfully defends Brooke Wyndham in a murder trial. Throughout the show, no one has faith in Elle, but she manages to surprise them when she defies expectations while staying true to herself. It was hilarious, fun, and lighthearted. Molly Smith as Elle Woods was brilliant, and every number in the play was entertaining and fun. Some favorites of mine were Blood in the Water, Ireland, Positive, and Bend and Snap. As you can tell, a lot of practice was put into this production, and I look forward to the next
one. Thanks for watching.
Be sure to tune into the next edition of LETV.